Hey guys, it's Flatback FX here, back with another tutorial, and today we're going to be making this matrix effect. So stick around, you're watching Flatback FX. Alright, so before we get started, you're going to want to download a font that I've put in the description below. Now the font we're going to use is called Matrix Code, and it's actually going to give us the font that they use in that Matrix Code. Alright, so once you've downloaded and installed that, then the next thing we want to do is come back to After Effects, and we're going to create our composition. So I'm going to right-click New Composition, and I'm going to call this one Text 1, and I'm going to make sure it's set to 1080x25, and I'm going to leave the duration at about 40. Alright, next I'm going to right-click and create a new text layer. Now this can be whatever you want, and I'm just going to make it nice and easy and just make this an A. Now it's important not to make this a capital A, just use lowercase, and I'm going to select that layer, and I'm going to change it to our font, which is our matrix code, and that's actually going to change the font. Next, I'm just going to scale this up to be about 59. Now, the color at this point is not that important, but just so we can see it, I've made it white. And then all I'm going to do is just move our letter straight up so it sits just on the top of our composition here. Next, I'm going to select that layer. I'm going to come over to our effects and presets, and I'm going to search for decoder fade in, which is this one here, and I'm going to drag that onto our letter. Next, I'm going to navigate down to our text layer animator, and I'm going to select this second keyframe here, and I'm going to move it out to the 12 second mark, so it's like that. So at the moment you'll see that it kind of fades in here. Now the other thing I'm going to do is where it says opacity under advanced, I'm going to turn this up to 100 so it stays like this the whole time. Now you'll see it's automatically jumbling the letter. Next I'm going to select my letter, come up to effect, down to color correction, and I'm going to add the tint. Now down under effects I'm going to open up the tint settings, and I only want to touch the white. So where it says map white to, I'm going to select a keyframe, and I'm going to go exactly to the 1 second mark, and I'm going to create another keyframe. Now at this point I'm going to select my white color, and I'm going to make this a green. Now I've used this exact green color here, so you can enter that number in to get the exact same color, and then hit OK. Now that'll set a transition from white to green as it goes along. Next I'm going to go to the 2 second mark. I'm going to navigate down to this transform and create a keyframe for my opacity. Then I'm going to go to 207 and then create another opacity keyframe. And I'm going to set this to be 0. Now if you're not sure, you're using this as your actual number. So I'm using this as my seconds and then frames. And if I just play through, this is what we should have now. Okay, next I'm going to select my layer, and I'm going to duplicate it. I'm going to zoom in slightly on the timeline here to make it easier, and I'm going to go across exactly 3 frames by using this, and I'm going to drag that layer across. So my second layer comes in at exactly 3 frames after the first one, and I'm going to move the position so it's directly underneath. I'm also going to select my layer, and you can change this to another letter. So I'm just going to go the next letter on the keyboard, which is S. Then I'm going to repeat this process again. So next I'm going to go along another 3 frames. I'm going to select my layer. I'm going to duplicate. I'm going to move this one so it comes in at 6 frames. And then I'm simply going to change this one to be D. And I'm going to move this one straight down like that. Next I'm going to go across again. I'm going to duplicate this one. I'm going to move it across. I'm going to bring this one down. Change the letter again. Duplicate it again. So I'm basically just repeating this process and working my way down the whole screen to create one full level. So it looks good if we keep changing those letters each time because it makes it more random. Alright, so once you've gotten a couple of letters, so I've got about 9 letters here, you can speed up this process by duplicating them all, dragging them all to the top, and then moving these ones across. And what I can do is shift these all down, so I'm holding shift at the same time, and moving them all down. So I'm just going to duplicate these ones, move these ones up to the top here, shift them across, and just keep moving them down like that until you hit the bottom. So now that I've reached the bottom, if I play through what I've got here, this is what we should have. All right, now that's pretty much the hard part to this process. So creating one strand. Now that we've created this one strand, we can just simply duplicate this to create our overall effect. All right, so now that we've created one strand, we're going to duplicate these strands in a new composition. So I'm going to create a new composition, and I'm going to call this one text 2, just to make it simple. And I'm going to drag my text 1 layer into this layer. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in slightly here, and I'm going to let this first strand come down to about here. Then I'm going to duplicate and start a new strand. Now with that strand, I'm just going to simply off-center it. Then I can duplicate this one again, and I'm going to off-center this one slightly again. I'm going to duplicate this one, move it over here maybe. So you can see what I'm doing here. I'm simply duplicating them and then moving them to a new position. So when you've got a couple like this, you can duplicate the lot, shift them all across to duplicate that, and then slightly off-center them. So it's just basically a process of taking all these layers, duplicating, and then off-centering them. So you keep moving them around to be as random as possible, just to help sell that effect as best you can. Now once you've got a good amount of layers here, I'm going to duplicate all of them again. I'm going to shift these over, start this whole process again, so they're sort of now starting to double up slightly. Might take some of these layers, duplicate them, and shift them over. So really, it's just a process of duplicating and layering them to get the effect that you're after. So you can layer as many of these as you want until you get the effect that you're actually after. So just keep duplicating these and then off-centering them until you get the effect that you're sort of after. All right, so once you think you've got what you're after there, the next step is we're going to create another composition. I'm going to call this one Matrix. And this time I'm going to drag my text 2 layer straight in. Now I'm also just going to create a solid background here and make this one black. Drag that one to the back there. Now at the moment we've got our matrix sort of code falling down, but at the end we want to sort of do a logo reveal or add text or whatever you wanted to add there. So the way we do this is we actually take one of our text 1 layers here and just drag that straight in. And I'm going to shift it so it comes in about here. I'm also going to drag it up, shift this one across so it sits about here. Now just to make it easy, I'm just going to turn off this second text layer so we can see what we're doing. What I'm going to do is go back to my text 1 layer, and I'm just going to simply select one of these text layers, copy it, and paste it straight into this composition here. And I'm just going to reposition this letter here so it lines up basically with this here. So we want it to basically appear right after this letter comes in here, so it looks like it's part of this chain. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down to where my text layer is, down to the animator, and I'm going to select these two keyframes here, and I'm simply just going to drag them over like that. So it sort of speeds up that process at the end there. Next, what I'm going to do is go down to my opacity on this layer and just disable it and make sure it's set to 100%. So the letter stays behind basically after the chain's gone. And what I'm going to do is select my text layer here, and I'm simply going to hold shift to make it uppercase and just type the first letter of the word that I'm going to be using. So in my case, I'm going to type out matrix, so I'm going to put an M. So you can see what we're doing here as the chain comes down, it's randomizing the letters and then it's settling on the letter that we've actually chosen. Now, if I select these two layers and I duplicate, I'm going to drag these ones to the top here. I'm then going to start this process again. So I'm going to go across three frames and move my letter across and also move these two chains across. Then I'm going to select my letter and I'm going to type out my next letter in the alphabet, making sure that it's an uppercase. So we end up with MA as the next ones. Then I'm going to duplicate these two, drag these ones to the top, go across another three frames and move them. And I'm going to shift these ones across and again add my next letter, which will be T. Now that I've got three letters, I can speed up this process again by duplicating all of these layers, dragging them to the top, and shifting them across three frames again. I'm also going to shift these ones. And I'm simply just going to change these ones. So that one to an R, I, and then X. So now if we zoom out and just play through what we've got there, we've got this chain of randomized letters as it ends up with our font that we actually want to use. And if I select all these layers, I can actually reposition them so they're more central. So something like that. Now if I turn on that bottom one again, we can see what we've got. Now if I want to make this come in a bit earlier, I can just select all those layers, drag them forward. So they're sort of hidden by that code slightly. Now the last thing I can do here is if I right click, I can create a new adjustment layer, and I'm going to come up to effect, down to stylize, and then add the glow layer. Now the glow radius I'm going to change to be 47. I'm going to change the glow intensity to be 1.1, and that'll just add a nice glow to the overall effect. So it gives us more of that matrix sort of glow. Now the last thing you can do is if I right click, I'm going to create a null object, and I'm just going to drag this under my adjustment layer and select all of these layers underneath except my background, and I'm going to parent them to this null object. If I go to my null object, down to transform, and add a scale keyframe, I'm going to go across to about 15 seconds and create another keyframe and do a very slight sort of scale, something to about there. And I'm also going to delay the start by dragging this up to about 2 seconds. I'm also going to right click and just make this easy ease. So that'll add a slight delay to our zoom. Now if I just play through what we've got here, you can see the full effect. So a few things just to keep in mind that you don't actually, if I go back to my text one layer, you don't actually have to use the matrix font. I can just use a standard ABC font and the auto generator will still randomly jumble those. So you don't have to use the matrix style font. That's just up to you and the look that you're going for. The other thing you can do is in text two, you can continue to duplicate these to layer them even more, or you can thin them out. You can make them larger or smaller, or you could even keep duplicating them to make the whole composition longer, depending on the effect you're going for. And the last thing is you can also duplicate this effect that we've used to type out our text to make longer words, and you could even have these text layers fade out and have a whole new text layer come straight in after. So there's a really quick and easy way to make this effect. I hope you've learned something, and remember, Flatpak Effects is the Flatpak anyone can build.